the word that will fall on good ground and will bring forth fruit in its due season. We thank you right now for everything that's done up to this point. Now, God, we ask you to take us just a little bit higher in your will and in your way. It is in Jesus' name we pray and say amen.
Amen.
I want you to be seated. And I want to leave a thought in your mind on tonight. The thought is, dreams do come true. Dreams do come true. The Lord has been dealing with me about dreams for a good little while. I'm not going to say when it started. Don't know when it's going to stop. But when Deacon Clark called me about coming here tonight, that's what God spoke into my spirit. Dreams. A lot of times, we look at just in the scripture, Genesis chapter 37, we're looking at Jacob. We're looking at how Joseph, who was the brother and the son of Israel, how he was treated by his siblings, how he was treated by his brothers because his father showed favoritism toward him. It was nothing that Joseph had done per se. It was just that his father liked him better than he liked all the other of his siblings. Therefore, those siblings that were doing things that were undermining their father's authority were not the ones that were the chosen brothers. So they decided that they did not like their brother because he actually cared about what his father thought of him. He was concerned about his opinion, about his father's opinion toward him. And that can be taken into context of today. A lot of times in our church and in the realm that we're living and walking in right now, people get upset. They get a little, wind in their jaws, wind in their cheeks when somebody is liked just a little bit more or favored, it seems, by God. Y'all thought I was going to say somebody else, but see, I'm not even working on church business. I'm talking about kingdom business. We are upset when it seems like God favors one over the other. When we understand and realize and recognize that he or she is serving the same God that I'm serving. So if they are being favored by God, something that they are doing for God to be working on their side. So we need to have a mind to understand that I need to figure out what they're doing to get God to do these great and wonderful things in their life, and I can realize what I need to do in order to get God to do these things in my life. But the brothers of Joseph did not have that mentality. They were so upset and disturbed by the fact that their father had made Joseph a coat. It was Joseph. He didn't say he gave him purchase. He said he gave him a coat. But they got upset about that coat. And then on top of the coat, here comes Joseph. Sometimes you can talk just a little too much. When God is dealing with you, sometimes you don't need to reveal everything, God. Sometimes you can push yourself just a little too far because you tell too much. If God is dealing with you upon a certain task or a certain thing that he's going to do in your life, sometimes you need to be careful who you take. Some people don't have your best interests in mind. Joseph told his brothers, those who were born from the same mother, born by the same father, some of them were born by the same mother. We have to understand that he told the ones he thought should love him and should have had his back. He told the ones he thought was going to be back behind him or right beside him. He thought they were going to be encouraged by what he said. But instead, they got discouraged, they got upset, and they started to have an attitude toward Joseph. How many have been there in your life? But people will get an attitude towards you about what God is saying in your life. But you understand, they're not getting an attitude towards you, but they're getting an attitude toward check on them. See what they're doing. Apparently, the
father did not trust the brothers that much.
That's
just what I get out of it. Y'all can look at it and see what y'all get. That's what I get out of it. He sent somebody to check on them. There must be something they had done before. He had learned some things. Sometimes we need to learn some things. That's free. That was from Chris.
Go ahead.
We have to understand that Joseph was doing the task that he was told to do, that he was sent to do. And here he comes down and they see him. They spy him along the way. Here comes the dreamer. They made it seem like it was something that he had done wrong. He did not dream the dream simply because he thought to himself, well, if I go to sleep, I'm going to dream that my brothers are giving homage to me. He did not do that. He did that because what happened was God revealed his life, revealed his destiny. Even though it was not yet happening, he gave him a glimpse of the glory that was to come. Sometimes in our own little minuscule mind, God will reveal to us the glory that is to come, and we will get so high-minded, so heavy, that we want to run ahead of God. Even though he revealed to Joseph what was going to happen in the future, he didn't tell him it was his near future. He did not know that he was going to have to go to a pit. He did not know that he was going to have to face false accusation, but he knew that he was going to do these great things. But God is saying to us today, even though you dream and dreams do come true. So I don't care what's going on in your life. I don't care what the devil has done. I don't care what Sister Kool-Aid said about you. I don't care what Brother Potato Salad said about you. You say that so you won't get up on his nerves. You got to understand that God is everything to you. And if God is giving you a dream, it's going to come to pass. All you got to do is keep your mind focused on Jesus. Joseph was here, and he was at the point, place in his life, where God was dealing with him. Plenty of times we are sitting here in the house of God, and we are given vision by God. God is dealing with us. He is giving us a vision of what is going to happen. And because we are so excited, Joseph was not bragging. He was just excited about what was going to happen. He was so excited that he didn't think about the fact of how it made his brothers feel. Sometimes you need to think about how people feel before you do things, even though it might be God's will.
Yeah.